talk about it by arriving and using it. How I want to use it, show a few things that we use. Get the guys without minimal contact and how we progress from here to say, let a contact situation. Show them different things we're looking at. And I might be in certain guys' case because I want reaction speed and things like that. So first thing I'll do is just walk through it, and then I'll show you guys what we're talking about, trigger points and things like that. Okay, so who's Shawnee, are you in or not?
Yes,
you're always in, Shawnee. Yeah. Who's Julio?
There's one.
Yeah. Let's get someone in the back here. Big shoulders, big shoulders.
Someone in the back, yeah?
Walk out here. So when we get from this, the biggest problem that we have with players is getting to the next round. So now we're going to have a, for this instance, move it in there, we'll make a decision, close him out, get in the ground there. Now we usually will have a 9 here, but just for this instance, I want him to scream, bounce. You want to move up, walk around, walk around the corner, over there. So this small thing here, it's not really about the drill, it's about the trigger words, the body position, and the other thing. And the first thing you need to do that is to carry the ball, how good is his vision, he's working his feet, he's working the same way, getting his eye, getting his tackle fight, did he win the tackle fight? And then from there on, Sean comes into his game again. Then he calls, return to action, then he calls it down. How quickly did RBS partners work from here to take this place here? So the next thing you get here, the first thing will be what? Reaction. So the first thing will be reaction. It's the same thing over and again. Reaction. Accuracy. Body eye. Double bang. All of those categories got like three different things I'm eating. For instance, the guy carrying the ball, did he evade? Was it a good tackle fight? Was there good presentation? Was there double effort? Then after that, did he call the down score? So that's the thing that you need to know. Alright, let's do one. Shall I? We'll start from here, making alpha up, work through straight, like you said. And one thing I picked up for all German players that I think is here is nobody talks. Very quiet, and that's why I'm saying you don't talk to the players. You're like, what is the difference for us? You
Because I don't want to talk about it, I just want to dance and let you do it today. It's part of it. The assistant supporter, how was his reaction speed? Was he accurate in the clean?
Very good. Usually she won't be able to get up there because there will be a lot of guys.
And also, this is normally we'll just take that guy, we'll take that guy to the ground and make sure he's not in the game, his decision making you gotta do. Alright, so we did, we get from there, reaction. Everybody happy with that? Just four little things. We'll do another one and then we'll get some guys involved.
Go, sorry, go in.
Go down.
That's it. Alright,
take your weight.
Up. Hey.
Buddy. No.
Bounce.
Okay, usually it's not at back. So, what we usually do, this guy sits as well. Alright, the nine double band here, 93 jersey. Bounce. Just go like this the whole time. With this guy here, we also take down this guy. Make sure you sit here. Yeah. You need to do nothing like that. Just, doesn't need to put him up, just to keep that finger. You don't want to put him up in the finger, they won't know if you're going to be in the back. Just keep it on the shoulder, he knows you have to be there. But it stays the responsibility of the guy that every time carries the ball. Yeah. To get over that voltage line and make sure everybody is involved in that run, get on the ground. And that's why we keep the guy on the ground. It's a very difficult just a small little drill that we put in place. Then we move over to this one.
One question.
Yeah, sure.
The drill was first one goes down, second man goes line over.
On his butt, low, in, sure. Shoulder. Yeah.
Down, no? Man. Not over. Yeah?
No. And okay. Then because if you hit him now, he can't move anywhere.
Yeah.
He may, you can now keep him whatever you want, double banky, but if you really went over, he can slide out and get more difficult to control. Is there anybody happy? Everybody should quiet. Everybody's happy. Okay. Everybody's happy. Alright, just let's shoot. I'll make this easier.
That's why I'm not happy.
Can we get three guys on the body shield?
I won't make the contact. So
can we get three guys, yeah?
Okay,
this side.
You outside?
Now we've trained it there. We're not on a contact in that way. So the players just need to keep it complete. Okay. Make sure the guys are still alive.
But as soon as the defense is not bagged anymore, it becomes a different situation. So then you have to do this all the same things over again. So what we will do in this situation is the guys will usually start on the stomachs here. We'll blow a whistle. Low body position. Now that's what you start off. So we just back in. Somebody start off on cover.
No, don't
worry. So for us now it's important to how quickly do we react to different situations.
We'll blow a whistle. The guys will low body position as we work there. Making sure body height is right. Head up. Dominate the space.
When they turn over here from line, they work back.
We'll have someone here.
This we'll pick one guy carrying the ball. Doesn't matter who, because it's a decision making exercise.
We'll pop in the ball and say, Sean, we're going to try and evade.
And then we want to see how good is the reaction from the second guys, what decision they make.
Do they pull it up? Do they pull it on the ground?
Or do we go and look at analysis and make sure? The fourth diagram, and that's the tricky part. Doesn't make it scrum off. We don't want to make quick ball slow. So for us, that's something that we will be moving towards is, doesn't matter who's got fourth or either. If the ball is available, we want him to play the ball. At the moment that we're battling at the moment, our nines are running, losing weight, because our guys are not used to it. One or two guys will do it, and this guy will come in and play the ball, and then down the ground ball. So he bounce, and everybody turns to action. Okay, so what I want to do, I'm just going to go slowly through it. So I'm going to pop the ball to you, just right. Yep. Next two guys make a decision where you want to go. No contact in it. Just keep away. Just to see what the drill is that we do. Alright, so I can't whistle. Alright, so let's just run it through quickly. You guys give me the things that we need to have.
Reaction.
So
it doesn't matter what's happening, we want to do quickly from
here. Reaction speed, when they get there, we go over and kick the ball to Sean. He's the first guy carrying the ball. He's got to evade. He's got to make sure he plays the ball properly, second in the best, all those things. The guys that are working around, same thing. Reaction speed, how accurate it was. Were we accurate then? Awful. Some of the guys don't make contact, but I mean, it's just basically for the drill, man. So make sure you're accurate, body position, all these kind of things are important. And then the third thing is, when the ball gets past there, how quickly you can get back on that. That is important. Alright, so basically all things are being, you always must evaluate it. Damage criteria. If that is what you think you've got to set up yourself, evaluate each and every session with that. Did we have action speed? Did we have activity? Did we have return to activity? Okay, that's the basic. Let's just give you one more. And I want to
sorry, coach, just a comment there in terms of what we did this morning. Ball carrying was assessed in terms of how much space is got. Work with and determine the skill set that it will draw from. So if he's in space, we chase our progression. Right step, handle, offload, pop. Right. But if the space is okay, we're going to look for the offloading. Then we just need money. Space, work through, ball, support him, just track him, talk to him, down, look in. If there's more space, the supporter's role will change. What about the space that they have? Well, wait a minute. Let's see, Shara.
Can I talk to anyone?
Draw from the right skill set. Yes, easy. Easy!
Hey, come.
Hey!
Let's stop. Quickly, if we validate that the old drill, let's start from there. Was your action speed good?
Yeah, good.
Listen. Dustin received the ball. Was that evasion good?
Evasion was there. It was a bit of evasion. Yeah.
Okay. So, the second part was what? What was his responsibility? Right, and then?
Secondly, move.
Was movement good?
No.
Was the ball placement? No, was there a second effort?
Wasn't.
Okay, so immediately if we think that box is something that we need to work on.
Okay, I was just using an example there.
So that's something we need to work on. Was there action speed and accuracy of the other guys good? So if you can take all
this, and you say, listen, well, like, breakdown is still not good, then you go back and say, like, so breakdown wasn't good, so of course, then let's go back to step one. Because the board carried dominant because that was the advisor. Did he have a second effort? No, we didn't. So we need to work and isolate our second efforts. So then we put in a little drill to make sure the second efforts are there. The guys understand why we need the second efforts. Okay, this is basically the things that we looked at.
Things like we can make a lot of contacts off.
There's many drills you can do. There's many things you guys do as coaches already, drills and breakdowns. But you need to have something to measure that. And say, listen, that's why so you can have a lot of stats or whatever, but at the end of the day, it's how you coach and you feel. What is the different steps that you're going to put in place to make sure that the players know why we're doing something? And that's why we're trying to break it down. So if you're first in arrival, what do you do? You know, all those little blocks that you want to tick. And if one of those boxes is ticking a week, instead of spending time on the whole thing, because you know, you have a lot of different aspects you want to coach, you say, guys, I see what you're doing. This is the reason why I'll take out a few clips. And then just put a little drill, a 5-minute drill if I'm breaking up a full session. Make it part of your warm up. Let's say, let's put the ball, let's get a second effort to watch it. Don't spend hours on it, because you'll waste time. Just see, alright, out of the 10 boxes I've ticked, one is a problem, 3 times in a match, second effort was a problem. So guys, 5 minutes quicker, it's working up the second effort. So second effort, you put it in the second one to break down. So I promise you won't be able to do every week a half an hour break. Take 5 minutes, put it in, second week, just work in aspects. Because these things you would have done pre-season already, making sure that everybody stands with you one, with all your dogs, and then just focus on a little small area. For Saturday you play again, not smash up the guys. Just work in a small area.